I exist primarily in wide open spaces, or sometimes small dark corners I can burrow into. I used to be afraid I'd become a god. Something worse. Someday, when the copium burn is harder than before, I'd fall down into a storm drain, pace around endlessly there, just as I do here, in my empty house, with its hollow halls. I have an inherent fear of being perceived, of strangers who tap my shoulders. They always say the same, requesting information like my house address or my shirt size, but I won't let them have it. I have Jesus Christ burning slowly out of an IV drip. You can rent my fucking head out of your local red box. I have held the weight of the world, and it is nothing but displeasing. Not heavy, nor burdensome, nor taxing, but only tainted with this hollow sense of unhappiness that doesn't go away. I pour all my energy into courtside, and I watch it fall through my hands like water or salt. I wait for it to sort me out. I wait until I can feel like I want to be alive. wander around. I wonder aloud. It comes over me in waves, and I let it wash over my head just the same. I'm green and gray in the back seat, taking myself down, falling heavily to sleep. Every morning is obscure, and I feel as if I'm watching it through a looking glass. My friendly face in the window appears every morning, and then I'm lost in the suburbs for the day, until a nearby plane flies overhead. Then tomorrow I'm counting tiles, building blocks and trains, the face in the window fog still there, the barn on the hill still alight, and a man by the pool not yet upstairs. The old black dog walks with me in life, not death, as do the others. Their darkness and light have not yet separated my mind. They are one. A car leaves sometime in the dead of night, leaving out for the highway in some far-off destination. It's ancient, 2007 to 2008. Before the asphalt labyrinths, there's dirt below the wheels. Lights below the stars, a neon cola sign on a passing gas station stop. It's been 2007, 2008, 2009, and tomorrow when I awake, it will be 2010. Not the year, but the age. Still sunrise. A car pulls into a suburban neighborhood, watched over by red tower lights where the heat often prevails. There's a pool in the backyard and a man sitting by it. Day passes to night. As the sun sets, I walk the tarmac maze with a little car. Against the horizon are steel skeletons flashing red. I'll never leave this moment. Stumbling around the dark room with a warm glow from a distant doorway, and out comes the cake, with candles alike. I'm having a great time. Gifts of cars with buttons, icing on my face, and I'm asleep. 2007 to 2010. The car arrives home in the morning. Hello, friend. This is the face in the window fog. The snow has already begun to fall. And Sometimes, in my dreams, I come back here. And usually it's empty, and a tired attendant passes me a room key. I crumple down onto the ground and fall asleep, knowing I'll wake dazed and confused on some random morning and do it all again in the springtime. I've spent hours and hours, and I've let myself die here, mulling it over and over and over. For hours every night before I switch off the big light to sleep. And now what is left for me but to stand cross-legged by the radio tower, mumble to myself. Thank you. this time. Something inside me can tell. Everything I thought I had left is just another layover I'll never make. I blink once, twice, and then it's over. Final curtain. Elevator doors close. I'm always here.
Mm-hmm.